गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द रिविजन ऑफ थर्ड चैप्टर, दैट इज़ द रंजीज वंडरफुल बैट. दिस द राइटर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज रस्किन बॉन्ड एंड द थीम ऑन विच दिस चैप्टर इज बेस्ड ऑन इज फिजिकल एक्टिविटीज एंड स्पोर्ट्स. एज यू नो, इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट अ स्कूल बॉय हु इज वेरी मच इंटरेस्टेड इन प्लेइंग क्रिकेट. So how was his journey, how he made attempts, how he tried the various things to be a good cricketer, that we are going to study in this chapter. This is a story from Ruskin Bond's book Ranji's Wonderful Bat and Other Stories. Ranji is an innocent, enthusiastic child who loves to play cricket. His dedication towards the game and dream of proving his worth inspires him to work hard and achieve what he wants. So now let's begin with the story. How's that? Shouted the wicketkeeper, holding the ball up in his gloves. How's that? Echoed the slip fielders. How? Growled the fast bowler, glaring at the umpire. Out, said the umpire. All of you must have seen this scene while you watch the cricket, that how all this takes place. Whenever there is an appeal from a player, a bowler or a fielder for the out, the rest of his teammates supports him, and finally the umpire gives his decision. And Suraj, the captain of the school team, walked slowly back to the pavilion, which was really a tool shed at the end of the field, because it was not good that the captain of the team was out. The score stood at 53 for 4 wickets. Another 60 runs had to be made for victory. And only one good batsman remained. All the rest were bowlers who could not be expected to make many runs. As you all know, whenever the serial is decided in the of a cricket team, the batsmen are kept on the first and then the bowlers, because the bowlers cannot make many runs as they are expert in bowling and not the batting. It was Ranji's turn to bat. Now from here the story of the boy is starting, about whom we are going to talk in this chapter. Now that boy came for the batting. He was the youngest member of the team, only 11, but sturdy and full of pluck. Means very determined, very much willing to do something good. As he walked briskly to the wicket, his unruly black hair was blown about by a cool breeze that came down from the hills. Ranjis had a good eye and strong wrists and had made lots of runs in some of the minor matches. Here some of the characteristics of his game are described, that he had a good eye, the strong wrist, and about the matches which he had played. But in the last two inter-school games, his scores had been poor, the highest being 12 runs. Although he was playing good, but in the last two messages he could not, in the last two matches he could not perform well, and his highest score was 12 only. Now he was determined to make enough runs to take his side to victory. And now when he came to the field for the batting with a will to make a good score so that his team can win the game. Ranji took his guard and prepared to face the bowler. The fielders moved closer in anticipation of another catch. As the first, the Suraj, the captain of the team, was out because he was, the ball was caught by a fielder. The tall, fast bowler scowled and began his long run, as the bowler used to run before placing the ball. His arm reeled and the hard, shiny red ball came hurling towards Ranji. Ranji was going to lunge forward, means to move forward, and play the ball back to the bowler. But at the last moment, he changed his mind and stepped back, intending to push the ball through the ring of the fielders on his right or offside. This is all about the language of the cricket, that how he planned to play the ball. The ball swung in the air, shot off the grass and came through sharply to strike Ranji on his pads. "How's that?" screamed the bowler. Now there was another appeal for Ranji. "Hopping about like a kangaroo." "How?" shouted the wicketkeeper. "How?" asked the fielders. The umpire slowly raised a finger. "Out," he said. Now Ranji was also out. And it was Ranji's to walk back to tool shed. The match was won by the visiting team, means the another team. "Never mind," said Suraj, patting Ranji on the back. "You will do the better next time. You are out of form just now, that's all." Now the captain of the team, Suraj, came to Ranji and he told him that, "Don't worry, if you could not perform well today, you are just out of the form. Means nowadays you are not playing good, but if you will keep on practicing, you will do good." But their cricket coach was sterner. Means here the team of the captain of the team was not very strict, but so was not the case with the coach. Means he must not be happy with Ranji as he could not perform well. "You will have to make more runs in the next game," he warned Ranji, "or you will lose your place in the side." Means if in the next game you will not perform well, you may be out of the team. Avoiding the other players, Ranji walked slowly homewards, his head down, his hands in his pocket. He was very upset as usual because he could not perform well. So his head was down and he was not in a good mood. He had been trying so hard and practicing regularly, but when an important game came along, he failed to make a big score. What is the reason? Why was he upset? Because he was practicing so much. He was following all the instructions. He was practicing regularly and very hard. But when the time finally came to prove himself, he could not do that. So that is why he was upset. It seemed that there was nothing he could do about it, but he loved playing cricket and he couldn't bear the thought of being out of the school team. Now he thought that he could not do anything about it, although he loves cricket so much, and he was very much afraid of being out of the school team. He wanted to be in the school team so that he can play a good cricket for his team. On his way home, he had to pass the clock tower. He often stopped at Mr. Kumar's sports shop to chat with the owner or look at all the things on the shelves. Footballs, cricket balls, badminton, racket, hockey sticks, balls of various shapes and sizes. So when he used to return back to his house, there was a shop on the way. It was Mr. Kumar's shop and it was a sports shop. So very often he used to go there to talk to the owner of the shop and to look around the various things that are placed in the shop, because he was very much interested in the sports. It was a wonderland where Ranji usually liked to linger. Linger means to remain at a place more than expected, to spend more time at that particular place. So it was his favorite place. But this was one day when he did not feel like stopping. But today, since he could not perform well in the match, he did not feel like going to that particular shop. He looked the other way and was about to cross the road when Mr. Kumar's voice stopped him. Now today, when he was not going to that shop, the owner of the shop called him himself. "Hello Ranji, off in a hurry today. And why are you looking so sad?" Now we asked him why he did not come to the shop that day and why he was very sad. So Ranji had to stop and say namaste. He could not ignore Mr. Kumar, who had been so kind and helpful, always giving him advice on how to play different kinds of bowling. Mr. Kumar had been a state player once and had scored a century in a match against Tanzania. Now the another reason why did he like to visit Mr. Kumar, that he, because he was a sports person and he used to guide him in how to play the cricket, how to do the bowling, and he also scored a century in a match against Tanzania. Now he was too old for first class cricket, but he liked encouraging young players and he thought Ranji would make a good cricketer. But now since Mr. Kumar was old, he could not play cricket, so he liked encouraging young players. That's why he also helped Ranji. "What's the trouble?" he asked as Ranji stepped into the shop. "Lost the game today." Mr. Kumar asked him why he was sad, and he answered he was sad because the team lost the game that day. Ranji felt better as soon as he was inside the shop. He was feeling very sad, he was feeling very low because he could not perform well for his team. But as soon as he entered the shop, he was feeling a little better. Why? Because this was his favorite place that was full of the articles or the objects of the sports. So whenever you have such a place, you feel better. Mr. Kumar was so friendly, even the sports goods seemed friendly. He liked that place so much that obviously Mr. Kumar was very much friendly with Ranji, but even the objects, the articles, the things that are kept at the shop seemed friendly to him. He was so much into sports. The bats and balls and shuttlecocks all seemed to want to be helpful. "We lost the match," said Ranji. Now what was the reply from Mr. Kumar? "Never mind," said Mr. Kumar. "Where would we be without losses? No, that it's not a big deal if you lost the match. It happens. Where we would without the losses?" Means someone has to win and someone has to lose. So this time you lost the match. "There would not be any games without them. No cricket or football or hockey or tennis." Means there is no game where there is not winning and losing. It happens in each and every game. "No carom, no marbles, no sports shop for me. Anyway, how many runs did you make?" Now the next question. which was difficult for Ranji to answer. None. I made a big round egg. That means zero. Mr. Kumar rested his hand on Ranji's shoulder. Never mind, all good players have a bad day now and then. Now, to console him, Mr. Kumar told him that it's okay if you scored zero. Every player had some good day or bad day. So, it was just like that. Today, it was your bad day.